I think if we look at the woman entrepreneurship in Indonesia, first of all, we have to look at the number of men and women actually entering the labor force in Indonesia is actually quite equal. At this moment, you know, a bit lower, but you know, that's the issue is not women entering the labor force. The biggest issue right now is women that is going into leadership positions. So they really stay in a certain position out of convenience on the work-life balance. So this is really the biggest. So when you say the question is this common now, having women actually, you know, have a multiple tasks, you know, working as well as, you know, doing her household chores? I think it's very common. And, you know, you see this more and more. But, you know, the interesting part is when women have to decide in terms of their direction of a career or their household in Indonesia, I think the priority will still lies in their families. So I have to say the cultural background of women being, you know, the caretaker of the family is definitely still there. Now, having said that, why I really believe in pushing woman entrepreneurship, because I do believe that one area that, I mean, entrepreneurship definitely in Indonesia right now, we're still below 2%, you know, 1.78%. So we're still below. Right? Our target is we have to reach 2%. Why? Because it is basically the driver of economic growth here. Now, the woman entrepreneurship, entrepreneurs are really the key because they really drive the economy from the sense of there, if we did the research, actually, I have an organization called GAPI, the Global Entrepreneurship Organization, and we did the research in terms of women entrepreneurs vis-a-vis men entrepreneurs in Indonesia. And sorry, I'm not trying to say that woman is better, but I'm saying is there are issues that women are leading in terms of, you know, they're more disciplined, hardworking, being able to multitask, you know, all this aspect. But the key challenge that women face today as entrepreneurs are that women doesn't have sufficient skills, so they need really more capacity buildings. But the biggest challenge is the access to financing. So that you know, today, women who wants to start up a business can't even go to a financial institution. They're not bankable. They need a man's signature to get even a bank loan. And I don't know whether you have bankers here, but you know, they are. I'm not talking about just here in Jakarta, but in many of the regions that we work on, it's. This is their biggest problem, you know. So it is important that we recognize this, that the woman needs to be supported in terms of creating and making them become entrepreneurs. And what we're doing at the moment, maybe I can share some of the work that I do, because I really believe that the woman empowerment is very, very important. So we create a very strong network of women. But what is important is, because due to, I see many potentials of women who wants to start a business but can't do it, what we did is we create an angel investment network for women. So what we do is we created a fund, a woman fund, in which basically I started very small. I started with all just my girlfriends. I said, successful businesswoman. I said, you put in your money, you know, rather than just spending for your one Hermes bag, you put your money here and start investing. So that's how I started, you know, with small women. Now we have quite a big number. We have now about 30, I think, already. But basically, how we started is that we start this woman fund, then we invest in the woman SME, woman startup. And believe me, there are so many so many potential women startup that that are looking for investors. But this is not just about the money. This is also about mentoring, because mentoring is a very, very big task of developing entrepreneurs, including especially women entrepreneurs. So while we are connecting the dots, trying to really create this network, you know, I think mentoring and mentorship is very important. When I discuss with many of my female friends, I always say this is not just about educating women or empowering women, but it's also a big part of it is educating the men, the male. Really, because they, you know, when we look at now, and many of the organization, many companies, when we look at their you know, work program, you start seeing that many men are actually more participative as well in taking care of the household. So sometimes when the kid gets sick, you don't need to, you know, you don't need only the wife to take care of it. The husband can also take care of it. So I think there's many. It's a very interesting discussion. But I think educating men is equally important. We have now looking into, for example, paternity leave instead of maternity leave. You know, in Malaysia they're starting paternity. I said, oh, maybe in Indonesia we should look at the same thing. Look at paternity leave. So this is not about just equal opportunity, emancipation. I think that's all. Yeah, but it's more of understanding. You know. What are the opportunities for women?